Hi everybody, Morgan with Event Answer here, and today I'm going to share with you how I made my no-sew, hands-free umbrella hat costume. So I'm making a jellyfish out of an umbrella hat so that I can be hands-free when giving out candy at my community event that's coming up. But I also love the idea of this because it's great for kids. You can put it on their head and they're not trying to hold an umbrella, hold their bucket, play games or gather candy, and it's totally hands-free for them. This is also super fun because it lights up, and I love that for safety reasons and for the cool factor. So let me show you how I did this and the options that you can do to make it your own.
The supplies I used for this project include a purple umbrella hat, an iridescent table skirt, these curtain lights, which is one string with six individual strings attached to it that dangle free, this 6-inch roll of tulle, as well as purple ruffles. I'll have links to everything in the description box below so you can find the same products that I'm using on this. Go ahead and open up the umbrella hat and turn it upside down into a bowl. Now this will hold it steady while we work on this, and make sure you have batteries inside your lights and go ahead and undo the package of lights. This umbrella has a front and a back, so what is facing the camera will be the back of the umbrella hat. And I'm going to take my battery pack here and attach it to the headband, the elastic part of this umbrella hat. And I want to make sure that the cord is facing towards the umbrella. That way the cord doesn't hang loose when I'm actually wearing it. I'm going to take this piece of duct tape that I've ripped in half lengthwise so that it'll fit between the cord and the on-off switch you can see there. I don't want to interfere with the switch mechanism, so make sure your tape is narrow enough so that that doesn't happen. And I'm just taping it to the umbrella hat because I want to be able to remove everything off of this umbrella later and be able to use it without the costume elements. So my strings here are made up of six individual strings. Now I have 8 ribs on my umbrella, which means I'm going to have all my lights on the front side and 2 ribs on the back won't have lights. So I'm going to find the middle section of light and attach it to the foremost rib of the umbrella, which will be right in front of my face. I'm just going to secure this with some binder clips and make sure I can get all of the spacing between my lights correct. The space between the strings of lights isn't quite the same as the distance between ribs, so they're going to get a little off center from each rib point, which you see there. That's why I wanted to start with the centermost one in front of my face and then work out towards the edges to make sure they were spaced correctly. So now that I'm ready to start gluing, I'm going to undo the strand of lights and make sure they're on the outside of the umbrella. Then I'm going to take my hot glue gun and on the low setting and place a dot of glue on the left side and the right side of that string on the inside of the umbrella, so the silver part you can see there, not on the outside of the umbrella. I want all of the glue and the wires to stay hidden on the inside because I'll be layering other things that will hide it on the outside. I also want to make sure that I'm gluing the wire down between the strands into place so that when I wear the hat, this wire won't droop between spots. So one or two dots of glue will be more than enough to hold the wire in place. And while the glue is drying, I'm just putting binder clips next to all my little glue dots. The hot glue does take a little bit of time to hold in place, and it really slows it down if you have to hold the wire while the glue dries. So the binder clips is a nice little tip. And I just repeat this process all the way around the umbrella until I got to the end of the wire that is attached to the battery pack. So I'm gonna put a dot right at the end of the rib and then string out about as much wire as I need. And then any excess wire I'm gonna fold up, and using a twisty tie, I'm just gonna tie it up so it's nice and neat and it's not gonna hang down on my head. And then I'm gonna put one more dot of glue down near the base, and that will hold everything in place. And then I just went around and removed all the binder clips before adding the next layer, which is the iridescent tablecloth. Now the tablecloth is about 30 inches in length, so it hangs about my waist. And what I'm gonna do is straighten everything out and find the end of the strand. Now it's got about 2 or 3 inches at the top, which is what I'll be gluing to. You want the fringes to be right at the edge of the umbrella. And I'm just gonna go around and start hot gluing that upper part, that 3 inches, to the inside of the umbrella. The most important part is keeping the edge of the fringe square with the edge of the umbrella. So it means right in the corners where the ribs are, you're gonna have a little bit of extra material there. So just try and fold it over and glue it in place, and then put glue dots all along the edge, and that will hold this in place. If you need to, you can even throw on some more of those binder clips to hold it until the glue dries. And I repeated this process all the way around the umbrella, gluing and folding at the ribs. The one thing I did was I only went around once with the tablecloth. There was enough material to probably go around twice, but I wanted to be able to see through this tablecloth pretty easily, so I only went around once. If you need to be able to see through this a little better, you can always pull off some of the fringe and thin it out to make it easier to see through. The next element is some coordinating tulle. So this is a 6-inch wide roll of tulle. I'm just gonna spool off a bunch of it and measure out 4 feet. And that'll be the midpoint of the strands. So my tablecloth is about 30 inches and then my lights are about 5 feet tall. And so I wanted the tulle to kind of be in between and bridge the gap between those. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut 8 of these, one for each of my ribs, and then I'm gonna cut those in half in a wavy pattern. And this, I thought, gave it a nice sea look. But I'm going to attach these to the ribs, and it's a very subtle addition. If you wanted, you could add a whole bunch more. I just thought this was kind of a nice accent. And then I'm gonna go ahead and glue them all down. So it's taking 2 pieces of the tulle. I'm gonna lay them on top of each other, put a line of hot glue right on top of that table skirting, right near the rib. I'm being pretty generous with the glue here. And then I'm gonna press the tulle into the glue, making sure that both of those pieces are getting stuck down. Now, if any of the lengths of these things, whether it's the table skirt, the tulle, or the lights are too long, you can always adjust the lengths of these things to suit your needs. So if this is on a child, you can always pin up the ends of the lights so that they're not tripping on them. The last thing I'm going to do is embellish the very edge of my umbrella. So I've got my purple tulle here. Now, if you sew, you could absolutely make your own ruffly tulle. But I didn't want to sew, so I just bought this, and I'm just gonna go along and hot gluing it right along the edge, one between the ribs, and then a dot of glue on each side of the rib just to make sure it got around the corner okay. And then I just repeated this all the way around the umbrella until I got to the end, and then I just eyeballed about where it ended, cut it free, and then I'm just gonna finish gluing that together. And that's the last little bit of embellishment. You could also take this ruffle up the ridges to the peak of the umbrella, but I thought it was just really cute along the edge here. And here's the finished project. Now, if you need to transport this, you can go ahead and close the umbrella. The important thing is to just make sure all the tassels and everything on the bottom don't get tangled.
I hope you found today's project inspirational. This was a lot of fun and really easy to put together. And it's really versatile, so whether you want to customize it for a Halloween costume, need it for a school play, or just want to have an under the water themed party, this works for all of those occasions. So if you like this, give this video a thumbs up. I really appreciate it and lets me know that you're interested in this kind of content. Also, make sure you hit the subscribe button below. I'll be putting up some holiday videos really soon, as well as more party decorations and step-by-step tutorials. So I look forward to seeing you in a future video, and until then, bye!